quite a bit of creative freedom. If you listen to their records, you'll see why they needed it. It's quite an inventory of styles that they go through on any given recording. They released an EP back in 86 called Come On Pilgrim that was followed up in 1988 by their first LP called Surfer Rosa. This year's release is called Doolittle. It's their second full-length LP. The band consists of a gentleman named Black Francis, whose name is really Charles Thompson. Go figure it. He and Joey Santiago were college buddies in Boston. They formed the band together and then put out advertisements to find the rest of the members. Well, bassist Kim Deal answered an ad that asked for somebody to play in a Husker Du, Peter Paul and Mary type group. She was amused, arrived with no bass, was the only applicant, and got the job. Her friend David Lovering was brought in to be the drummer. The Pixies are featured on this week's Inner Limits.
I get the sense that the songs are like experiments that you perform one at a time and you're putting them together. Is that an accurate way of looking at it?
That's a pretty good way.
How would you describe the process of putting together a Pixies song?
Well, it's kind of like an experiment we do one at a time. It's less like that, I don't know. To make a cool rock tune, that is our goal. And we live for only that song when we're making that song, and you know, we're trying to make it good.
That's what it sounds like. It doesn't sound like you're intentionally trying to create a bunch of songs that have this particular style to
them. No. I appreciate bands that have they're very stylistic and remain in their particular corner of sound or persona or image. I like that, but we're just not real good at that. Better just think about a one little 2-minute experience and try to make it good.
What type of experiments do you do? If a song becomes an experiment, what does it become an experiment in? How loud you can do it, or how short it can be, or what extreme feelings you can express, or how do you approach it?
To make it sound cool. That's the experiment. We don't like go, wow, how loud can we make the song? That's not the experiment. The experiment is just, wow, this is going to be another song.
We try to reduce it to what it was like when we were 13 or 14. You first start playing guitar in your friend's garage, and you just make a bunch of noises, and it's fun, and that's sort of what we do. We try to keep that same mentality, even though we're not that age anymore, and we're certainly not as immature as that. We're very mature now, but I mean, you know what I mean.
You try to keep it primitive?
Yeah, it's somewhat primitive, but I mean, yeah, kind of. I guess just like simple and stupid, and for no particular reason at all, except to make a bunch of rock music.
So I've read about your family background as being a religious one. How does that find its way into the music?
Mostly just in the memories of Bible stories of the Old Testament and things like that, you know.
Lyric references?
Yeah, lyric references, you know what I mean?
What about in delivery of the songs?
People could say that, like, you know, he's got that preaching kind of vocal style, but I don't know if it comes from watching a lot of that. I certainly have seen a lot of that and been around a lot of that, but I don't know. I listened to, like, my Iggy Pop albums about a zillion times, too, so that might have something to do with it, too, you know? I really don't know which it is.
Is there that kind of anger in your songs that you hear in Iggy's music?
No, there's no anger. It's just the entertainment. I mean, I'm really just trying to entertain.
It seemed to me that there's something a little more confrontational than mere entertainment in the songs that I've heard.
Well, I mean, you know, I mean, like, sort of macabre or the dark side of life and all those sorts of things are like staples in literature or any sort of other sort of art, probably more so than upbeat, happy, humorous type things. And so when I say it's just for entertainment, it doesn't mean that it isn't reflecting on darker kind of things, but it's still, those are entertaining things to sing about, I guess, or write about, or talk about, or film, or whatever, you know.
What are your obsessions that you bring to music?
I don't know, it's more vague when it comes to rock music. It's more vague, I think. We just have a bunch of chords, and we gotta fill up spaces and put some words in there, and I don't know, I'm in a naive kind of way, I'm trying to like be like surreal or Dada, you know, kind of like that.
I know that you're responsible for writing most of the songs, but do you pull the fellow band members in at a certain point saying, okay, I've gone this far with it, can you help me take it to the...
Yeah, sometimes it's really crude and there's hardly anything there. Sometimes it's more developed than other times, you know. Just sort of, whenever we all get over to Dave's garage and plug everything in.
How do you like making videos?
Good, because we actually make them, and we hire our friends to put them together, and we make them ourselves, so it is a lot of fun. We have small budgets, and
Do you treat it as, I'm just running into so many bands these days who tell me that they hate making videos, that it's a complete burden, and I'm wondering, do you treat it as a challenge that goes along with the challenge of making music?
Yeah, it is a challenge because even though it's a promotional thing, like an advertisement, I think most people that make videos, they don't have any respect for the song because they're treating it as a promotional thing and not as, this is a song and that's the source document for this, just like a book or something else. It's, well, you're not like showing a snippet of a song, you're playing the whole song and you're experiencing the whole audio thing of this is their whole song that you're hearing. And they forget about that. And then also, as far as filmmaking or TV hobbyists, I think it doesn't have a lot of respect for that. It's not cool enough. All them budgets and all them cameras, and they can't come up with anything better than that. I mean, I just think it's really...
No, you go.
Well?
You go, David.
We've got flowers. How much? We've got a lot of flowers.
$500 worth of flowers.
Had a little set with the... cloud backdrop, some curtains on the side, littered the flowers all over everything. And we shot the video. And we did it all in a day. And if you watch the video, you'll notice the flowers will die for the course of the video.
Yeah, it's
as
good.
They
it's
went
good.
Along. Little hint there. But we did the video, we're doing the editing and putting it all together, and it was just boring as hell. Just terrible. So we were a little like off the rockers. We were fooling around with the video effects and made the head stretch. And it just seemed so funny that was the video. It made it less boring.
Many great things come out of boredom, I think.